I played trumpet in the band in seventh grade, blasting out songs at football games and fall parades. We'd ride the bus to the small towns like Winfield and Downsville and Colfax, in purple jackets and white slacks. We were the Braves, we were the Jack Hayes Braves, named after a dead administrator and the noble idea of the young Native American male. School ambassadors, a popular song and goodwill. Mr. Minifield was our director, skin the color of a brown paper sack. He was black, trying to teach us white kids to play, but confronted every baton-breaking day by juvenile delinquents like Danny Amos, who locked himself into Minifield's office with my Ted Nugent double album, playing Wang Dang, Sweet Poontang, full blast over the band room speakers. And I remember Minifield just sitting there, staring out into the air from the podium, smoking a Camel, looking straight ahead, imagining himself somewhere else, I'd guess, where he'd be getting paid more for less. Yes, tomorrow morning we'd be marching. What's ahead, what's behind, just another step in time. Valerie played clarinet, 13 going on 35, sexy in a hard way like a first cigarette, bourbon spill on a bare thigh. Yeah, you could say she was ahead of the game. She'd barely speak to me, so that 2-hour ride felt like an all-day tense erotic dream. Staring out at the pine trees and red clay, the country stores where inevitably an old dough-faced man would be standing outside, staring at us like his life going by. Was that her leg? Was that her leg just brushing against mine? Was cold, the silver bell of my horn shining back, convex reflections of faces and hands, and the yellow smear of the bus while I blew out my spit valve, put the wax on my braces. Yeah, we were getting ready to play, standing in line, moving in formation. First up, a Stevie Wonder song called Sir Duke for Ellington. I didn't know that then. Chameleon by Herbie Hancock, jungle boogie by Cooling the Gang. KC and the Sunshine Band get down tonight. That's when I saw him at the end of the block, Imperial Knights of the Ku Klux Klan. In their white dunce caps and robes with red crosses embroidered on, like gilded leaves on an automatic rifle, or an image of the suffering Christ airbrushed on the side of a missile in broad daylight. Donald Lovelady said he thought they only came out at night. Like an apparition, blood real in the silver sun. Between what's ahead, what's behind, just another step in time. They were handing out tracts to the Caucasian mothers and daughters and fathers and sons of Colfax, laughing and joking, kneeling down, placing a gentle hand on a child's blind head like Santa Claus or the Pope, like this was normal, like this was okay. Another doo-dot date down in Dixieland. He didn't say a word. Minifield didn't turn his head, just kept marching, looking straight ahead, looking straight ahead. Like there was somewhere better he was going, but this was the only goddamn way to get there today. Hey, with his baton in the air, looking straight ahead. Straight on. Straight ahead.